Agua. It is a Portuguese word for water. Last month, however, it morphed into a byword for eschewing Coca-Cola. Encouraging people to drink water, it is what Portugal captain Cristiano Ronaldo uttered after putting aside two bottles of the popular beverage before the start of his press conference at the European Championship. What was seemingly a flippant reflex has now acquired the face of a minor controversy. Several outlets reported that Ronaldo's actions were responsible for a $4 billion tumble in Coke's market value. It's amazing how much influence an influencer can have on the stock market as well as the brand's value, and apparently, Cristiano Ronaldo's Coke and water gesture in a press conference perhaps did not fail in that regard. We are in a new era where athletes seem to be reclaiming their voice. They now speak to reserve the right to speak and behave in ways that are consistent with what they think, what they feel, what their values are. The gesture of putting the bottles aside caused a brutal 1.6% drop for the company on the stock market. For brands and those who manage them, these actions speak louder than the loudest words. Visual action of this kind, and that too at a press conference viewed by millions across the world, is just too big to ignore. Actions such as these have a way of going viral, and a digital estimate puts together 1.2 million memes and 220 million repeat views of this action at Euro 2020. That is huge. An action where a star replaces one brand with another, or as in this case, a brand with a generic item called water, Ronaldo therefore just de-endorsed Coca-Cola. A brand de-endorsement that occurred at a very high viewership event, press conference. Is brand de-endorsement the new thing ahead? The brands in question just did not expect or want this to happen, but it did in succession, whether planned or spontaneous. And actions such as these could continue to happen as a cascade of events that will shake and stir the world of brands and brand endorsements. The real point is that brand endorsers cannot be owned by companies. Every brand endorser is a mind, body, and soul on their own. They are indeed living beings who will take actions as they will. Never mind iron-jacketed contracts at play. Well, there comes a time when the brand endorser thinks more of his viewers than the brands they endorse. And tipping points such as these can come very easily. Brand endorsers could do this to a brand they endorse or to a brand they do not endorse equally, as in these cases. From a pure consumer point of view, Ronaldo is a hero on and off the field after this action. Consumers love icons who take care of them and their health, and from the brand's point of view, they are nightmares the firms can do without.
I think it is natural for celebrities who are conscious about their own brand to be choosy about the kind of products that they endorse, right? And these days with social media and, you know, everyone having a point of view, I think celebrities and brand ambassadors in general have become far more selective about the kind of brands that they want to support. And I think it's perfectly natural. You know, I hear people saying that about 15 years back, XYZ had promoted a soft drink or promoted junk food. I think that's fine because, you know, social mores have changed over time, right? 30, 40 years back, it was okay to be promoting a cigarette brand. But today there's a lot of emphasis on health. There's a lot of emphasis on nutrition. There's a lot of emphasis on staying clean. So if celebrities have a change of mind and they decide to keep off junk food or keep off certain categories, I think one has to understand and expect that. Having said which, I think brand custodians and business owners have to be far more sensitive, right? If you're looking at someone in, let's say, a sporting arena, then expecting him to endorse junk food is not good for your brand. It obviously is not good for your celebrities. So I think businesses have to examine their choice of ambassadors basis the true values of that person, not just as, you know, I'm going to pay you money, so say what I want you to say.
Brands and their managers might just have to rethink their actions and their endorsers with a hand on their heart, wherever that is. Firstly, are brands saying the right things to their consumers? Plus, the brands that are socially ostracized categories like alcohol, tobacco, high fat, high sugar, and high salt for a start will not get stars to endorse them in the near future.
I think brands have to be more sensitive. Like in the case of a soft drink brand, I know all the large companies, they have a range of offers, right? There are a lot of healthy drinks within a soft drink company's portfolio, right? They have water, they have juices, they have sports drinks. So I think integrating those products with celebrities makes more sense with a sporting celebrity. However, there are other categories, right? Today, if you have a stand-up comedian, he would be pretty happy to endorse, you know, some of these, let's say, sugary drinks or some of the snack foods. So I think there are no hard compartmentalization. But I think for a brand, the best strategy is always to have a celebrity who seems very authentic, right? It makes more sense when a celebrity can be the kind of person who actually uses your brand in his real life. Then there's a far more bigger synergy, right? When you see a Shah Rukh endorsing a Hyundai Santro, there's a little bit of unbelievability in it, right? You know that it's because of an endorsement contract, right? But if you were to see, let's say, Shah Rukh endorse a high-end car, it would seem pretty obvious, right? You would assume that he rides one of these expensive vehicles. So I think, therefore, brands have to examine the kind of fit they have between their personalities and the personalities of the celebrities that they want to have to endorse their brand. I think until that thing comes clear, consumers will always begin to see it with a little bit of a, you know, skepticism. And it's also true because in this world of, you know, micro-influencers, today everyone has a voice, right? Everyone has an Instagram or a Twitter handle. So people are quick to, you know, point out these incongruities. So I think brands have to be sensitive and to make sure that the celebrity is the kind of person who is likely to be a user of your product in the real world.
Well, brands in these categories might as well draw out their own mascots and build them to be their brand endorsers in the near and distant future. We are entering a very exciting age of consumerism and brands ahead, an age where everyone will think of the good of all as opposed to the good of a few.